I'll just start. Let me present my screen. So today we are going to have a look at the coal reserves of India. Okay, so the different coal, so the geological and geographical distribution of coal fields in India. So I have given here this particular website, which is from Geological Survey of India, where you can go and download a PDF, and you will find a good amount of discussion on the same topic. Okay. So let's begin. This is a map of India, of course, you can see, and it shows the disposition of different coal fields that we have in India. Okay. And you can see, essentially, there are three categories. One is the Permian Gondwana coals, then you have the Eocene coals, then you have Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene, and Pleistocene coals. Okay. So the numbers are put in the map as well, that denotes the different coal deposits. So one denotes Damodar Valley. Let's find where one is. So this is with the Damodar Valley coal field. So this is this is the Gondwana coal field, belongs to the Permian age. Then two is your Koyal Valley. Okay. Three is Son Valley. This is the Son Valley coal field. Four is Mahanadi Valley. Okay. Five is your Godavari Valley. This is Godavari Valley. And six is, of course, your Satpura Basins. Okay. This is in Madhya Pradesh. You can see they are generally distributed in West Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and in Andhra Pradesh. Okay. And Odisha, of course. So this is more or less where our major coal fields are. But other than that, there are also some, not so significant coal fields, but there are coal fields. Okay, say for example, number seven is your Rajmahal coal field. There is a little bit of, most of it is not actually mined, the Rajmahal coals. Then eight is your Deogram Hazaribagh group of coal field. People do mine coal from Deogram and Hazaribagh. And then nine, you have little bit of lignites in the Darjeeling as well. Okay, you find coals there. In the northeast as well, you have the Gare Hills, Khasi Hills, Jayantia Hills, Mikir Hills. Also in Jammu and Kashmir, there are some coal. Okay, there is some sporadic deposits of coal in Rajasthan, like the Palana coal field, and Gujarat also in Kutch, which is the lignite field as well. Okay. Rajasthan and the Gujarat are your lignite fields. And then you have some northeastern coal fields like Upper Assam, Neyveli, then Kashmir lignites. Okay. So they are not very big coal fields, but there are some sporadic production of coal from them. Okay. So this is an important slide for you to actually remember, because you often are asked questions about the different coal fields of India. Okay, so although this today's lecture might not be scientifically challenging much, it's more descriptive. But in any exam that you might ask for, NET, GATE, or in GSI, today's class is fairly important, because people do ask questions from India's coal deposits, okay? Because India's economy, pretty much a lot of it is dependent on India's coal, okay? And this is the main source of the power for India as well. So, it has a lot of economic importance. And so it is very important to take you through the different coal fields, okay? So let us first look at the Gondwana coals. So in India, 99% of our coal production comes from Gondwana coals, and they are found in three geological units. So the geological units are called Raniganj Formation, Borakar Formation. So Raniganj comes from Upper Permian, Borakar Formation, and Karhadbari Formation, that is your Lower Permian coal. So Karhadbari Formation is the oldest formation in India where coal is found. The Gondwana coals of Permian times are found in the peninsular Gondwana basins of India. Okay, so these are all mine. These, you know, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, these are all my Gondwana coal basins, right? They are my Gondwana coals, right? So Upper Permian and Lower Permian coal. Okay, that is where you have 99% of the of the coal coming from. Okay, and we said that they are generally into three formations: Karhadbari, which is the oldest, then Borakar Formation, and the Raniganj Formation. The next slide here, I'm going to show you the basic stratigraphy of Borakar Formation, the basic stratigraphy of Permian coals, okay, the Damodar Valley coal field, the Gondwana coals, okay. And this is also a very important slide. People do ask a lot of questions from the stratigraphic column. Okay, so you should actually remember this stratigraphic column by heart for many exams to come. Okay, so how this Gondwana sequence essentially comes? So you have the Precambrian group of rocks where you have granite, gneiss, schist, amphibolite, quartzite, and pegmatites. Then I have a non-conformity. Then I have the Upper Carboniferous group of rocks and the very famous Talcher group of rocks. Okay. Talcher group of rocks. So that is also called Talcher boulder bed. This Talcher group of rocks are often called Talcher boulder bed. Okay. And that belong to Upper Carboniferous boulder bed. Okay, what does it contain? Fine to medium grain, greenish buff colored sandstone shell, turbidite. It has a lots of pebbles because, you know, it's a boulder bed, so you have a lots of pebbly conglomerate sandstone. Okay, that is what contains your Talcher. But then neither the Precambrian nor the Talcher, they contain gold. I mean, they don't contain coal. Okay, so the first coal you will find from the Lower Permian, so Karhadbari Formation as well as Borakar Formation. So here you can write Borakar as well as Karhadbari. Okay, both are there. And what does it contain? Conglomerates, pebbly sandstone, very coarse grained to fine grained sandstone, gray shell, carbonaceous shell, fire clay, and coal seams. Okay, so it is. That's what the basic lithology, but you can see that both Borakar and Karhadbari contains coal seams. Okay. Now in the Upper Permian, the more prolific coaly formation comes back, that is the Raniganj Formation. And Raniganj Formation also produces a lot of coal. So fine-grained sandstone, siltstone, carbonaceous gray shells with coal seams. Okay. And then this 550 meter, that is the general depth that is being said here. Okay, and Borakar, the general depth is around 610 meter from the ground level. But the Borakar and the Raniganj Formation is separated by something called barren measure. So barren means there is no coal. Barren means absence of. Okay, so the reason it is called barren measure because it doesn't have any coal. So we have the Borakar Formation, which is Lower Permian, which has a lot of coal, and then the Upper Permian Raniganj Formation, which also has a lot of coal. But in between these two, I have like a carbonaceous shell, gray micaceous shell, iron stone bed, siltstone, sandstone. Okay, so that is in between Raniganj and Borakar. Okay, and that is what we call as the barren measure. And after Raniganj, we have the Panchet Formation, which comes from the Triassic. This fine-grained sandstone, green shell, red chocolate-colored shell clay, and you can also see Panchet doesn't have again any coal. Okay, so the Upper Permian Raniganj and the lower Permian, Barakar and Karharwadi is where you find coal. Okay. And then Upper Triassic, Supra Panchet or Mahadeva formation. Okay. That has carbonate conglomerates, ferrogenious sandstone and siltstone. And then Jurassic has intrusives, basic, ultra-basic dikes and sills and lamprophyres. And in the recent, we have alluvial laterite. Okay. So this is a typical Gondwana sequence. Okay. Typical Gondwana sequence from Damodar Valley. Okay. In GSI, you are often asked to write this stratigraphic column and you have to mark where your coals are. Okay. So this is something to remember. This particular stratigraphic column is one of the most famous stratigraphic column of India. So something to remember. Okay. Talcher, Barakar, Baran Major, Ranigaj, Panchet, Supra Panchet, and then recent intrusives and recent. Okay. And that is how it becomes younger. My young in duration. Okay. So how do you remember it? Of course, you have to essentially read about it, mug it. Okay, now let us look at different coal fields. The first, the most famous coal field of India is the Raniganj coal field. It's the most famous coal field because this produces the maximum amount of coal. So it's situated in West Bengal. Raniganj coal field is the important coal field. This coal field is the easternmost Damodar Valley coal field. If you just look at the picture here, where it belongs, this is the Raniganj coal field. You know, the Raniganj coal field is the easternmost coal field, partially in West Bengal and partially in Jharkhand. So partially in here it is written Bihar, it's actually in Jharkhand, okay. Both, so you can also Jharkhand, okay. Next to Jharia coal field, this is the most important coal field in India. It is situated about 185 kilometers northwest of Calcutta. The field is named after the town Raniganj, which is situated in the southeastern part of the field. The coal field is surrounded by Archean rocks on all sides except the east. Coal-bearing Gondwana strata lie beneath the alluvium cover. Okay, so if you remove the alluvium cover, then you will find the coal-bearing Raniganj formation. Okay, so this actually is looks something like this. It has a gentle dip. So some places, so this is your ground, okay. In some places, because of the dip, it is fairly close, okay. The depth is not very, very, this is the coal seam, right? Not seam, seams actually, more than one seams, which belongs to Raniganj formation. So where it is close to the ground, you can do an open cast mine. So you have open cast mine here. You also have where it is fairly deep, there you do underground mining, okay. So Raniganj coalfield has India's deepest mine, and the name of the mine is Chinakuri. Chinakuri 1, that is the deepest mine of India. Goes all the way around, around 600 meter, I guess. Fairly deep. The coals of the Baran Major are low in, sorry, sorry, coals. So this is the so from the Raniganj formation, they also mine from the Raniganj form. So in the Raniganj coal field, they also mine from the Raniganj formation as well as from the Borakar formation. But the coals from the Borakar measures are low in moisture, low in volatile matter, whereas the Raniganj measures are high in moisture and high in volatile matter. Okay, so that differentiates the grade of the coal. Okay, so you of course want low moisture, low volatile matter coal. So Borakar is in that way better. Okay, in general. So other coal fields found in West Bengal are Barjora and Birbhum coal fields, and then Darjeeling coal field. Okay, but Darjeeling, although it belongs to the Gondwana group of rocks, it's Darjeeling coal field also is from Gondwana. Okay. That's the first coal field, and then we are going to look at the next coal field. So coal fields say of Jharkhand and Bihar, about 1/3 of the estimated coal reserves are distributed in Jharkhand and Bihar. Okay. Important coal fields of these states are Jodia, Bokaro, Giridih, Karanpura, Ramgarh, Daltonganj, Auranga and Hathur and Hutar. Part of the Raniganj coal field of West Bengal also falls in Jharkhand actually. Coal fields of the Damodar Valley are the chief source of metallurgical coal. We talked about metallurgical coal. This type of coal is used for your iron ore industry in the country, and most of the iron and steel plants get coking coal from these fields. Okay, it's the major source for coking coal as well, other than the coal that you burn. Then Jodia coal field is the source for primary coking coal. This is where you have most of the coking coal coming from for the iron ore industry. It's one of the most important coal fields of India. The coal field is situated around 260 km northwest from Calcutta in the heart of Damodar Valley. Okay. The coal field is within the district of Dhanbad. The field is roughly sickle shaped. Okay. The coal basin extends about 38 km in east-west direction and maximum of 18 km from to north-south, and covers around 456 square kilometer area. Okay. The general stratigraphic succession of the area is basement metamorphic rocks are overlain by Talcin formation, as we have talked, and then you have Borakar, and then we have the Raniganj formation. The Raniganj formation is the uppermost formation in Jodia coal field as well. So you find Raniganj coal, Raniganj formation and Borakar formation both in Jodia coal field as well as in Raniganj coal field. Okay, so medium volatile coals contain 26 to 28% volatiles, low volatile coals contain up to 26% volatile, and high volatile coal contains over 28% volatile. Okay, the coals of the Raniganj formation have slightly higher moisture content than the Borakar formation, which we just discussed. It's nothing different from the Raniganj field. Then you also have Bokaro coal field. Okay, you can read about these things, so I am not getting into the details of them. So the Bokaro coal field is also very similar. Okay, the things that you have to remember here: the lower coal seams are grouped as so in the East Bokaro coal field, there are two coal fields in Bokaro coal field. Okay, one is called the East Bokaro coal field, and the other is West Bokaro coal field. In the East Bokaro coal field, several coal seams are within the Borakar formation. Okay. You are still in the Damodar Valley, so you have Borakar formation. Lower coal seams are grouped as Karo group. Okay, and the out of these seams, Karo lower measures and Karo upper measures are worth mentioning. Okay, so you know, for example, the question might come, they give you the Karo group of seams come from which coal field, okay, and then give you multiple choice sort of question. So you need to remember this time Karo Scardo Coalfield actually comes from Bokaro. Okay, and then West Bokaro Coalfield. The Boracar Formation is coal bearing and embodies 13 seams. And you can see here in Bokaro Coalfield, we are not mining from the Raniganj seam. We are mostly mining the Boracar seam, right? And then the ash content in most of the seams, the ash content is higher than 25%. So it's not very good quality coal. Okay. So most of the coals make medium coking coal. Okay. And then Karanpura Coalfield. Karanpura Coalfield. In the South Karanpura, this good development of Talcher and Boracar formation, most of the coals are non-coking. Okay, you don't generally find good coking coal here. Okay, but so the best coking coal is belongs to the Jhoria Coalfield itself. Then North Koyal Valley Coalfield. There are three coal fields in North Koyal Valley. Say for example, Auranga, Hutar, and Daltonganj. So this is the name Koyal essentially comes from the river Koyal, which is a tributary of the Son River. Okay. And Hutar and Dalton coalfields are of economic importance. In Hutar coalfield, the coal seams are in lower Boracar formation. Okay. So they have low volatile matter and low ash content. Then Deoghar Coalfield. I don't know if you know the name of Deoghar. This is also a very famous pilgrimage place. So here you get isolated lower Gondwana coals. These basins are northwest trending belts and located in the Santhal Parghana district of Bihar. Okay. The coal seams are reported to occur Karharbadi coalfield. Okay. So you get Karharbadi coal from Deoghar. Okay. So if someone asks you where do you get Karharbadi coals, it's like the Deoghar coalfield. Okay. And then Rajmahal coalfields. The coal fields in this area are assuming of importance lately. The unique location of these coal fields at the southern bank of the Ganges offers good possibility of supplying coals to major power stations of North Bihar, North Bengal, and Bangladesh. Based on the coal fields of this region, a super thermal power station has been built at Farakka. There are 5 coal fields in this area. Coals in this region are subbituminous to high volatile bituminous, but Taj Mahal coal fields do not really produce a lot of coal. Okay. Then we come to the coal mines of Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. Okay, and they are called Central Indian coal fields. The famous coal fields are Singroli, Sohagpur, Umaria, and Joholia coal field. Okay. So Singroli coal field is situated mostly at the border of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Okay. In this coal field found Boracar and Raniganj formation coals, again Namadar Valley coals. Okay. In Sohagpur, which is in the Son Valley, this Barmni Chilpa fault trending east-west has divided the field into two parts. Okay. The southern part of the fault, there are 5 coal seams within the Boracar formation, and the coal contains 4 to 7% moisture, but high ash content. The Numaria coalfield, the coalfield is situated on the Umrar River tributary of the Son Valley, Lower Gondwana coalfield. Lower Gondwana coals are explored from there, and Johilla coalfield. And this is also on the Johilla River. So Talcher and Boracar and Raniganj beds are present. Okay. So it's important to note down the names. Okay, then you have Satpura coal fields. So the Satpura coal fields lie within the Pench Kanha Awa Valley, which is very close to us actually from Bhopal. Okay, south of Narmada River, known as the Satpura Gondwana Basin. In this region, Gondwana lie in a syncline trending east, northeast, west, southwest. Important coal fields in this area are Mopani coal field, then Pathakhera coal field, Kanha Valley coal field, Pench Valley coal field. Okay, they all the coal still are from Gondwana. Okay, say for example, for Mopani, it's upper Gondwana rocks. Okay, in the Pathakhera, coal seams have been encountered by boring. I mean, the top seam is poor quality and other seams are comparatively in better quality. They are also from the Raniganj and Borakar formations. Okay, then Kanha Valley coal fields. Kanha Valley are characterized by coking, particularly Damua, Kali Chapar and Rahi coal collieries. These are the famous collieries from this region. Okay, and then Pench Valley coal field, they also take out coal from the Gondwana coal fields. So in Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, we have the Central Indian coal field and the Satpura coal fields. Then we'll look into the North Chhattisgarh coal field and South Chhattisgarh coal field. Okay. So in a North Chhattisgarh coal field, you need to remember the names: Tatapani, Ramkola coal field, Chilimili coal field, Sonhat coal field, Chilimili area, Kurashia area, and Visrampur coal field. Okay. All of them do not actually produce a lot of coal. Some of them do, some of them don't. But one thing to remember, I mean, you don't have to remember all the details, but what is important to remember is, you know, the names belonging to these coal fields, of course, the specific name of the coal fields, and they all take out coal from the Gondwana formation, okay? Both Raniganj and Borakar. In some places, Borakar, in some places, only Raniganj. Then South Chhattisgarh coal field. We have Hasto, Rampur and Arand coal field, and then we have the Korba coal field, okay, and the Nand Raigarh coal fields. Okay, they all belong to Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, and they all take out coal from the Gondwana formation. So the website that I have given you, it's important that you go back there and you know, take out these names, read about them as much as you can. At least a brief description about these coal fields will be good for your exams. And coal fields of Maharashtra, the first one, the coal fields of the Nagpur region, like the Kemti coal field. This coal field is situated about 19 kilometers northeast of Nagpur. This coal field can be called as the hidden coal field, as the coal bearing rocks are not exposed anywhere. Okay. Later geophysical prospecting techniques was applied in this coal field for the first time for exploration of coal in India. Detailed exploration has proved large deposits of coal in the following three blocks. Okay. High workable seams have been proved over three blocks. Moisture content of the coal varies from 8 to 11%. Then Bokhara coal field, this is situated 9 kilometers northwest of Nagpur railway station. 7 coal seams have been proved. Then Umrad coal field, Umrad is a small town situated around 44 kilometers southeast of Nagpur, and this coal bearing strata is nowhere exposed as well. Then Vardha Valley coal fields, these are all in Maharashtra. Okay. Vardha Valley coal field situated in the valley of Vardha River, lying mainly in the Chandrapur district. The coal fields extend in northwest southeast direction over a distance of 115 kilometer covers an area about 4130 square kilometer. The coal bearing Borakar rocks. Okay, we are still in the formation is still Raniganj and Borakar. Okay, till the Permian coal. So that's why I asked you to remember that stratigraphic column, because they are so important in not only in West Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar. They're important in the central India, both Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. They are also spread over Maharashtra. Okay, the same stratigraphy more or less continues. Okay, hence that stratigraphy, the remembering that stratigraphy is very, very important. Okay, so coal fields of Andhra Pradesh. The important coal fields lie in the Pranhita Godavari Valley. Okay, it's the extension of the Vardha Valley actually. Okay, and you also still have the Gondwana coals. Okay, the important coal fields are Tandur, North Godavari, South Godavari coal field, Karalapalli, Karam, Karmamam, Karmaram, Karmaram coal field, yeah, Ramagundam coal field. Okay, so these are the important coal fields of Andhra Pradesh. Coal fields of Orissa, they are also still, we have the Namodar Valley coal field, right? They are still, we have coal fields from Gondwana, but there are also some tertiary coal fields in Orissa. Okay, there are some tertiary coal fields as well. So Athagar basin, Gaisilad basin, then Athamalik basin and Kathranjia basin. Okay, so these are the basins which are important in case of Odisha. In the upper Gondwana coals, the upper Gondwana coals are generally present in Gujarat. They are of subbituminous type coal, is found in association with upper Gondwana sediments of Cretaceous. Okay, so far what we have been looking at was in the lower Gondwana coal. Now the upper Gondwana coal, which is essentially in the Mesozoic, not in the Permian, they are found in Gujarat, okay, in the district of Kutch, Surendranagar and Mehsana. Okay, but they are mostly lignites. Then we have tertiary coals. So far we have looked at the Permian coals, the upper Gondwana, the Cretaceous and Jurassic coals, and now we are looking at the tertiary coals, which are in the stratigraphic column, right? So where do you find tertiary coals? We find them in Meghalaya, Assam and Arunachal Pradesh, in Nagaland. Okay, and then we will find them in Jammu, and then of course in Gujarat. Okay, so in Meghalaya we find them in the Garo Hills, Khasi Hills, Jayantia Hills. Those are the areas we find them. The typical age is Paleocene and Eocene. The Shilet limestone formation, especially the Lakadong sandstone, is the principal coal bearing horizon in Garo. This is something important to remember. Okay, this is something important to remember. The Lakadong sandstone, principal coal bearing horizon in Garo. Similarly, in Assam, it's also tertiary coals, Assam and Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. The major coal fields are Desai Valley coal field, Jhanji Valley coal field, Najira coal field, Safari Valley coal field, Jaipur coal field, Makum coal field, Namchik Namphuk coal field, etc. Okay. But they are all tertiary coals. Okay. And then, of course, in Nagaland, Borian coal field is the important coal field of Nagaland. Okay, and this is nothing but the extension of the Najira coal field of Assam. Okay, their weekly coking coal. Of course, we have coal in Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, the important coal fields are Kadu, Kalakat and Metka, mostly lower Eocene coal. Okay, lower Subathu group. So this is important to remember, the coal measures belong to the lower Subathu group. Okay, when you read about the stratigraphy of the Himalayas, the Subhatu formation comes in your mind. Okay, so that Subhatu formation essentially contains coal, which is tertiary coal. Okay, the uneconomic Dhan Sawal, Sawalkot, and other coal fields of the southern margin of the Pir Panjal range, and the chain of economic coal fields comprising of important coal fields like Kula, Kalakot, Metta, Mahagola, Chakkar, stretching roughly around northwest southeast to the further south of the Pir Panjal range. Jammu coals are generally low in moisture and volatile matter and highly variable in ash content. You can see the variation 9.7 to 45%. Then in Gujarat, ONGC, while drilling for oil, has come across a large reserve of coal, around 63 billion tons. The really, really big deposit, okay? At a depth ranging from 700 to 1700 kilometer in the Kalol Mehsana district of Gujarat, the coal associated with shale, claystone, sandstone occurs in Kalol formation. Coal associated with shale and sand also occurs in Kadi formation. Both the formations are of Eocene age. So this is coal, and then we have some lignites. So coal means we are generally talking about bituminous coal, okay? And lignites are treated as lignites. So large lignite deposits are found in many countries like Germany, Australia, USA, China, Canada, Italy, Turkey, and of course in India. The utilization of lignite in various industries and power generation are gaining importance. Okay. In comparison to coal, it is low in ash and sulfur content and also creates less environmental hazards. Okay, so in that way, it is good. But of course, the calorific value of lignite will be lower than the calorific value of bituminous coal. The occurrence of lignites in India is known in Tamil Nadu, Pondicherry, Karnataka, Andhra, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan, and Jammu and Kashmir. In India, Neyveli lignite open cast mine in Tamil Nadu is the largest mechanical mine producing 24 million tons of lignite annually, generating power with installed capacity of 2490 million megawatt. 2490 megawatt. So 24 million tons. So this is another important information to remember. Neyveli lignite field. Okay. So that is more or less what describes the basic coal fields of India. Anyone has any question around it? So I have to read about it. The link that I have given, I have taken all the slides from there only. I mean, the information from that link only. So you go to the link and then you will find this document, a PDF, where a good description of the Indian coal fields are given. Okay. I know it's a little bit mundane to remember and boring, but then, you can't escape it. There are some parts, I mean, they are important economic deposits of India. So you have to remember them, some of, at least the names. What sort of, I mean, where do you find what sort of coal? Okay. I mean, which state, what are the major coal fields? Yeah, what sort of coal are there? The general stratigraphy of the Gondwana formation. That is what you have to remember. But that's how it is. I think what I will recommend that you can make from this document, you can make a table for yourself. You know, that you can keep yourself remembering both for your course as well as for later the exams that you are going to sit for. Okay. I can tell you there are a lot of questions in NET and in GSI specifically from this particular class that we have talked about today. Okay. Although it is, I understand it's not very scientifically challenging. Any question? Okay, if not, then please remember that on 30th, I think on Friday actually, which is 30th, I guess. Yeah, we have the external lecture. Okay. And then I will see you on Monday again, when we will perhaps talk about Colbert-Wiesen. Okay, thank you very much.